Divine Truth Spirit Discussions. Discussions with people who have lived on earth and who have now passed into the spirit world. Jesus and Mary helped Mark, a 50-year-old cattle station owner who was shot dead and who attempts to understand spirit life. This discussion was recorded on the 24th of November 2015 in Wilkesdale, Queensland, Australia.
Yeah, sound on, sound recording for both of us. I might just do a little introduction into the camera.
Yeah. You know, you need to. This
but you may have to just cut the bit between the pause between after I've introduced and Mary starting her channeling.
I think I'm pretty ready.
Yeah. Okay. Welcome everyone to our presentations again in our studio here at Wilkesdale. I'm here with Mary today and we've decided to do a bit of ad hoc channeling, so we'll see how that goes. We did some over the weekend, but unfortunately we didn't record any of it, so unfortunately you won't benefit from it, although the spirits who we did it with would definitely benefit from it. But we'd like to now take a bit of a pause while we basically set up and Mary relaxes a bit, and then we'll get going with the channeling.
Okay, so there's a man.
Yep.
But he's pretty he's distressed.
Yep.
So I'm finding it a bit challenging to tune into him properly.
Yep.
But he's panicking. He wants help.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So his name's Mark, so I'm just You gotta help me. Mate, I need your help. I need your help now. I don't know what's going on and I need your help.
Mark, just breathe slowly and relax. Yeah, you can relax. The reason why you're panicking is because you're not allowing yourself to feel things. So
that's bad.
Yeah, well, you can explain to me how bad it is in a minute. Just let yourself relax first, because otherwise I won't get a clear feeling or a clear picture from you of where you are and why you're so panicked.
I don't know what's going on.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been in the spirit world?
I've got no idea.
No idea?
No.
Does it feel like a long time?
Is that where I am? I don't know.
Yeah, that's where you are.
What's going on?
Well, when you're on earth, you didn't believe that there was a spirit world, that there was a bit, you didn't believe there was an afterlife.
I didn't think about it.
No.
But something bad has happened.
When you say something bad has happened,
I don't know.
Perhaps you could explain what you feel that is.
I was just going about my business.
Mm-hmm. On earth?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you remember what you were doing?
No, hang on. I don't know. I was with my mate.
Yeah.
And then something bad happened and I don't know what happened.
Yeah. But what's happened already and it can't happen again, so you don't need to worry so much about what's happened. It's just a matter of trying to trace the events back. Does that make sense? But you're now passed. You've now died.
I don't want to know what happened. It was really bad and...
Perhaps what we can do... Just relax.
That was with my mates.
Yeah.
And we were shooting. And all of a sudden, I got shot.
So when you say you were with your mates, where were you? Can you remember?
In a scrub.
In a scrub where?
Oh, I don't know.
You know the locations and stuff, so.
Oh.
It's all right, just breathe. It can't happen to you again, so just breathe and let yourself remember. That's fine.
Oh. We were pigging. We were shooting pigs.
Shooting pigs, yeah.
On my property.
Yeah, where's your property?
Oh. In the Northern Territory, I've got a property. I've got a big property.
Yeah.
We went out in a ute.
Yeah.
In the...
Do you remember what day it was?
A Tuesday. I think it was night time.
Night time? Tuesday night? Okay. Just keep breathing. You're just remembering the events, that's all. Right? You just got to let yourself breathe, yeah, because you're remembering an event. And it's a matter of just breathing and letting yourself remember the event. Yeah. It can't happen to you again, so it's just a matter of remembering what happened.
I can't remember quite how it happened.
Mm-hmm. Let's just go rewind a bit further. All right, just breathe. Not quick, just slow. Just breathe slowly. Deep breath in and out. Deep breath in and out. And that's it. Deep breath in and out. Now, I've got a mate who's going to come to you. All right? And he's just going to be with you while I'm talking to you. Is that all right with you?
Okay.
You see the mate now? So this will be the first person you've met since the event.
Can you help me?
Yeah, he'll help you. I've got to explain how he can help you first, though. Does that make sense? So we need to talk to you, and you need to just allow yourself to breathe and be calm.
I can't see him.
That's okay. He'll just. Just keep breathing.
Oh, I don't know if I can trust him. Can I trust him?
Yeah. He's my mate, so I know you can trust him, but it's up to you. Like, it's up to you who you trust and who you don't trust. The key is that I just wanted someone around you so that you can feel some feelings that you need to feel, and then you can learn a little bit about your new life.
All right?
You don't have to affect the person who's channeling so much. Like, you just let them... You just allow yourself to... feel what you feel. The event's already happened and your physical body has gone already. In other words, you're no longer connected to your physical body anymore. So there's no danger of there being any future damage to you through your physical body. Does that make sense?
I can't let go of that. I can't
let go of
It hasn't stopped happening.
No, what happens is that you're replaying the event over and over to yourself, right? Right, and you don't, and...
I don't know how did it happen?
Well, I would say from what I can feel from you, you were with your mates and there was an accident really, was there? Or, and unfortunately one of your guns went off. And that's the last and that's the last thing you really remember, isn't it?
Yeah, it was a shock.
Yeah. The first thing is my friend can help you with some of the pictures going up or leading up to the event, if you allow him to do so. It's important for you to do it because in some ways you need to stop replaying the event over and over. Does that make sense? And one of the reasons why you're replaying it is because you're not allowing yourself to feel your fear properly, which is about breathing deeply in your tummy. So you've got to keep breathing deeply, just breathing deeply. You also, what you believe in the spirit world often is what's going to happen. So if you believe it's going to happen to you again and again and again, that's what will happen. So you've got to stop seeing that. You have to start seeing that there's no need for you to go over and over the event, aside from remembering the event and just letting yourself feel your feelings about the event. Does that make sense? Yeah. How are you feeling?
Pretty scared.
Yeah. The main reason why you're frightened, though, is not so much about the event, but it's about where you are now. You've been confused for some time, haven't you, as to where you are?
Yeah, I don't know what's happening, and I don't know. I just feel in...
Can I ask you what attracted you to us? What did you notice? What caused you to come here?
I don't even know. I felt like... I felt like I needed help.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
I couldn't make sense of anything anymore. And I couldn't, for the first time, I could feel like something kept happening.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, I couldn't even... I was just like a dog chasing its tail all the time, again and again and again and again.
Yeah.
And I can't make it stop. And
maybe I can, the first thing I can do is help you remember, but you've got to keep breathing to help you remember what happened, okay? What I'm going to do is take you back to the day of what happened.
Now since we've been talking, I remembered what happened.
Yeah. Yep. What kind of guns were you travelling with?
Well, semi-automatic guns.
Yeah.
And some shotguns.
And some shotguns.
It's a mixture.
Yeah.
And we were on the ute, me and my mate Tom.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, like, we were just having beers.
Yeah.
And joking.
And who was driving?
My other mate.
Yeah.
Jono.
Yeah. And you were in the back of the ute.
Yeah.
Yep.
Me and Tom and then all of a sudden we were laughing, we were joking.
Yep.
We couldn't see any pigs. Tomo dropped his gun.
Yeah.
And it went off and it got me through the head.
Yeah.
I didn't even really know what happened till I started talking to you.
Yeah.
I thought someone must have killed me.
Yeah. Just an accident.
Yeah.
Obviously the back of a ute, guns and some drink and Not a very good mix.
It wasn't so clever.
Not so clever, but that's the way it goes.
We've done it 100 times before.
I know you had.
It sounds like we got an arsenal there of guns. We didn't have that many guns.
I know. We had a few guns and a few high-powered.
We like our shooting.
Yeah, I understand. A lot of guys in Australia are the same, hey?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just never even knew what... I just knew fear feeling.
Yeah.
Panic.
Well, the reason why you haven't moved from that point is because you're not used to being able to feel fear. And so that's why every time you got close to feeling fear, you would go away from it, and that caused you not to be able to remember. Does that make sense to you? But me just getting you to breathe and calm down a bit and breathe and just breathe into your tummy and just have deep breaths causes you to relax a bit. And when you relax a bit, that causes you to remember things better.
It helped me know what happened, but it happened so fast.
Yep, a lot of people on Earth die very, very quickly and so fast that you don't even realise what's happened, really. And there's not much pain involved necessarily with it. It's just
It was shock.
Mm-hmm.
Shock. Suddenly
you're at a different place, weren't you? Can you remember?
Yeah.
Yeah. What would that place look like?
But I don't know. I couldn't. Yeah. Everything scared me.
Yeah. Yeah.
There was the shock, the gun, the pain. Sudden. It was pain. Just brief.
Just
but pain.
Very brief light.
Yeah.
And then you were...
Dark. I was in dark.
Then you're dark again. Yeah.
But it wasn't darkness like just in the night when you go out the back.
It's sort of like a murky darkness.
Yeah, and it felt bad.
Yeah, because there's a lot of other people around you that you can't see.
Yeah.
And they don't feel very good to you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's why you're scared, you see. It's not really to do with the death so much as to what happens straight afterwards. It causes you to be afraid. See, when you're...
But it's not like that now around me? Is that because...
Well, that's because you're here with us, and also the person I've asked to come to just help so that I can speak with you, he's protecting you from the influences that are around you at the moment. Does that make sense?
Yeah. No, I can see him now.
Yeah. So he's protecting you from those influences. So that helps you not be so tuned into, you know, what those guys or and the primarily men around you, what those men around you feel.
Hell, I didn't even know it was people around me. Just thought it was, just felt bad.
Well, they felt to you like almost like demons or like...
Oh, it just feels like a feeling, you know, like when you...
Of foreboding.
Feel like something bad's gonna happen. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
You just feel it in the air, you know?
Yeah.
You feel that feeling like, oh, something's up.
Yeah. And you're so scared that you can't allow yourself to even see those people. That's part of the problem. Does that make sense? You don't see them as people. You're sort of seeing them as sort of ghostly spirits, if you like.
Yeah, I wasn't seeing nothing. Now.
No.
Yeah.
Well, the man who's with you now, he's providing, you know, what's his name?
Bob.
Yeah, he's providing a bit of light for you, isn't he?
Yeah. He's a nice fella.
Yeah, he's a nice fella. And he's had a similar background to you in that he was on Earth.
Yeah.
Right. What is it now?
Oh, I've cucked it, haven't I?
Yeah.
I didn't know. I didn't really realise.
In other words, your physical body is dead. That's true.
Yeah, that's...
And you're not on Earth anymore.
Oh, that's a big deal.
Well, when I say you're not on Earth, you are still here, but you're here as in your spirit body.
Oh, I had so much to do.
I know. But sometimes a lot of the things we think we have to do aren't that important, actually.
I need to see what's going on in my place.
You do, but before you go, can I explain a few things to you?
Yeah, okay.
Is that all right? Because if you go to your place, there's a high likelihood you'll get all sucked into your place and become very frustrated because there'd be nothing you can do to help your place because you're a spirit. Does that make sense? And so you'll be you'll feel frustrated and annoyed, and you'll be frustrated with family, friends, and what they'd done after you passed, and all these kind of things.
Bloody hell, I wonder what's happening.
Yeah. Well, the key is to not worry about it. We'll go with you in a minute to see what's going on, and then maybe you can come back. But before we do that, we probably want to explain to you a few things. Is that okay with you? Because it's really important that you understand a few things that you didn't understand before you passed.
Yeah, okay.
All right? Okay. Well, firstly, as you've now seen, you have had a physical body when you're on Earth. Yeah?
Yeah.
And obviously when you were shot, that physical body died.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? And then as soon as the physical body dies, there's a cord that is between the physical body and the spirit body, which you're now in. If you look down at your body, you can see your body's not in that good nick. It's not very good. It's got all these problems with it. Yeah, can you see that?
Yeah.
And that's your spirit body. Now, your spirit body, you carried around with you on Earth, but you weren't aware of it at the time.
What?
Does that make sense? Ask the questions you want to ask. That's fine.
Well, that's a bit weird.
Yeah. What's weird?
Well, I had my own body. I was doing...
Yep, your physical body.
Living.
Yeah.
It was my body. What do you mean I had another body?
Well, there's this, every person when they're conceived, there's two bodies that are created at the same time that are connected to the same person. Does that make sense? Yeah, no, what I'm saying is true, because if it wasn't true, you wouldn't even have a body right now, right?
The hell's this body been?
Well, the body's been with you all the time, but it's just you couldn't see it before because you were looking through your physical eyes, and the physical eyes generally can't see a spirit body. Does that make sense? There are some people who can, but not many.
Yeah.
Right?
Wackos.
Well, that's what you think, but now you're a spirit, so I don't know if they're that wacko. Huh?
Yeah. Well,
so obviously... Everyone who's ever been born on Earth has two bodies, a spirit body and a physical one. The physical one is what's used to interface with the physical world, and the spirit body is what's used to interface with the spirit world. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I'm real worried about what's happening with my kids.
I know. You stay here with us for a bit, though.
Yeah. Okay.
Because the more you worry about those things, the more you'll be drawn back without understanding what's going on first. Does that make sense? It's far better that you understand what's going on before you get involved in what's going on. Because otherwise you'll get involved and you'll be confused and you won't know what's going on. And that will just take you back to a place of confusion like you were in before. Do you see?
Yeah.
It's far better if you can educate yourself a bit about the spirit world without too much judgment, because obviously you didn't believe in an afterlife and now you're in one. So obviously
you had
a very loose concept of the possibility before, right?
It's just heaven from as a kid I learned about.
But even that wasn't something you believed in greatly, was it?
Never even thought about it much.
No.
Too much to do.
Well, you're very bound to your earth life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is now your danger, to be honest.
Why is it a danger?
Well, because you're now in a spirit body, and if you stay bound to the earth life, you're going to find life very frustrating because there's not much you can do on the earth when you've got a spirit body. Does that make sense?
Well, what's the good of the bloody body if I can't do anything with it?
You can do a lot with it, a lot more than what you can do with your physical body. And that's what we want to teach you a bit about, because if we don't teach you about it, you'll feel limited.
Yeah,
And you'll also struggle a lot in your future life in the spirit world for a while. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So it's far better if we can explain to you.
Oh, I want to know what
some
I
things,
do.
You know. Yeah. It's a bit like anything, you know, if you can find out as much about the truth as you possibly can, it's always going to be of benefit to you, isn't it? If you think about it. Like... if you find out how things work, but like you're used to, you know, looking after your vehicles and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
Now, you know, imagine if you didn't know how to look after your vehicles, then you'd feel all confused when it comes to, you know, looking at a vehicle, wouldn't you? Particularly at its engine. But once you've learned a bit about looking after a vehicle, then you can get the best out of it, and you know how to repair it, and you know how to do things to it properly, right?
But you're saying that I...
Go on.
Well, it's... that I can't do any of that stuff anymore. Like, I'm in some weird new place.
Well, you're only in the beginning of a new place.
Well, I never even thought this could happen.
No, that's right. Most people on Earth don't, you see. And that's part of the problem, is that nobody gets educated on Earth about what happens as soon as you die.
No.
And most people are not interested in it because they want to avoid the whole concept of death in the first place. So we don't, we sort of like, we try to blanket out, right? We know we're going to die sometime, but we're not interested in finding out about it.
Well, my policy always was work hard.
Yep.
Look after your family.
Yep, but that doesn't stop you from dying.
No, but that's the thing you should focus on and just
live your life. Well, yeah, see, my feelings are that your life on Earth is very short in comparison with your life in the spirit world, so it would be wise to learn. Go on. So you live at the most, what, 70 to 100 years on Earth?
Well,
if you're lucky. And you, it wasn't that for you. How old are you?
50.
50, yeah. So, you know, you live 50 years on Earth. And the rest of your life now is going to be in the spirit world.
And what? How long do I get this body for?
Forever, pretty much.
Am I going to die again?
No, you can't die again. So that's one blessing.
Yeah, but what? It seems like a bit of a waste, all that shit I did on Earth.
Well, it is in some ways, because if you don't learn about your future life, then you finish up having a lot of problems in that future life because you haven't learned about it. It's a bit like, you know, buying a car and never learning how to fix a thing. Sooner or later, there's going to be problems with it, and you've got no way of fixing it. And that's the issue you face now. If you don't find some information about the spirit world and your body and what's going on before you go back and check everything out back home, the problem is that you probably will stay in this real frustrated place for a long time.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
It's just a bit of a shock.
Yeah, no, it's a shocker, right? Shocker, right?
But I see your reasoning.
Yeah.
It's good to, well, now I still can't even believe that I'm here.
Yeah. Yeah. Most people, when they pass, don't believe they've passed for quite some time, because most people on Earth are not educated about it. So most people who pass over to the spirit world have no idea they're there, even when they're there. That's part of the problem, right? That's what causes the confusion and also causes a lot of your fear. A lot of your fear is the result of not knowing.
Yeah.
Not knowing what's going on.
All right.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So what we need to do is explain to you what's going on. So what date do you think it is?
1984. 7th
of September, 1984. Okay. Well, the actual date is actually now, it's the 24th of November, 2015.
You're having me on.
No, I'm not.
What?
You've been in the fear place for over 32 years, or 31 years. And actually, many of the friends that you had have also passed. In that time. And the reason why it's been such a long period of time before you've realized what's going on is because there's so much fear that you're in that you keep revisiting over and over again, like replaying it for years and years and years. And you've been replaying your fears over and over again now for nearly 2 years.
Well, that one's got me. well, I don't know what to do. Nothing makes sense.
Yeah. Well, for the last 31 years, you've actually been in the spirit world. But you've not been aware that you're there because you've had so much fear that you've got close to feeling and then stepped away from every time. And so you've been in a panic for 31 years. That's why you were so distressed when we first met you. Does that make sense?
I suppose.
And because you were unaware of your environment, which wasn't very nice, and there's a lot of, and we'll show you a little bit about the environment in a protected way, so you can see where you currently are. Because it is a fair, you know, you need to see a few things about your environment too, that we need to show you. And that's why I asked this spirit friend to come, Bob, to come, because he is the person who's going to be able to show you some things about where you are now. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. And
so is it always nighttime here?
No. No, it depends where you are, and that's one of the things I'd like to explain to you.
Okay.
Okay. Now, in the spirit world, there are many locations, and in fact, at this stage, it is known that there are 36 different universal locations in the spirit world.
So, like...
You can think of it as 36 different types of heavens, if you like, but they're not really heavens, because I'll explain to you what they are.
Like me going to Brazil or going to NZ or going to...
Yeah, it's similar to that, but I need to explain to you how you go from one place to another and so forth.
Okay.
Does that make sense? But first, if we look at it, you're in the very first of those 36 locations. And that's called the first sphere or the first dimension after you've passed. Does that make sense?
Makes sense.
That's where you are.
Haven't done much moving since I got here.
No. Because you've been in that fear state for a long period of time and been quite frightened for a long period of time.
You've blown my mind with how long.
Yeah.
I can't.
It's pretty amazing, isn't it?
Oh.
Yeah.
It's a shame.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, a lot of time go past when you're sort of living in some emotions that go over and over and around in circles again.
I guess I just got to get on with it now, though.
So your own property at home would have changed quite substantially in 30
years. Oh, who knows what they've done.
And who knows who it's been sold to and what's happened, and do you see? And that's why I say it's good for you to know a little bit first, because... You know, going back home and checking it out, you'd wonder what's going on and you'd be all confused, and it'll just add to your confusion, do you see?
Yeah.
So it's far better that you know in advance what's going on.
Oh, I feel real sad. I had a lot going on.
Yeah.
And now who knows what's happened.
How old were your kids?
Jeffrey was 26.
Yep.
Susanna, 19.
26 and 19. They lived at home with you still?
Jeffrey worked
with
us. Susanna, not so far away.
On the property, on the station?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, your wife, how?
Yeah. I wonder how she is. Yeah. We didn't get on that well, to be honest.
Yeah, which is one reason why you went out shooting with the mates a lot.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
I hope she's all right, though.
Well, what was her age in 1984 when you passed?
Oh, 44.
Okay, 45. So she's now 31 years older than that. Does that make sense? So even if you went back there, you'd probably not even recognise her if you didn't know that.
So... Would my dad be here?
Your dad would be in the spirit world, surely, yeah. Yep, he passed. He's passed, isn't he?
Yeah, and my aunts and stuff like that.
Yeah, all the people that were passed by the time you passed in 1984 would all be in the spirit world somewhere.
So this is where we have to go like going to visit the other spheres to see them?
Well, yeah, they'll be in different places depending on a few things, and that's what I want to explain to you.
All right.
It's important that you understand how you get to different spheres in the spirit world, because there are some spheres that you at the moment cannot get to, and there's quite a lot of them. In fact, you cannot get to any other sphere other than the one you're in at the moment. And there's a reason why that is. Yeah. Well, what God designed, and you didn't have a very definite concept of God, did you?
Oh, mate, now you just better watch. You're not going to get all religious on me.
No, I'm not going to get religious. It's all pretty scientific, actually. But it'll require a bit of your understanding, firstly. But let's go back to your spirit body and your physical body. So here you've learnt a new thing, right? That you now have a spirit body.
Yeah.
And you had a spirit body all the way along, but you couldn't see it.
Yeah.
So there's a whole heap of things. So that would tend to suggest that there's probably a whole heap of things you can't see.
So like when I'm on Earth and I'm doing stuff.
Yeah, you're cruising around in your physical body, yep.
What's the spirit body doing?
The spirit body
tap
is
dancing?
It's with you the whole time. It's just the way it looks at the time is that the spirit body is inside of it. It's actually surrounding, but it appears inside of the physical body. So if you look at it, you know, when you go and investigate this later, because you will be able to investigate the things I'm telling you.
Yeah.
You'll be able to see that the spirit body and the physical body are together whenever a person is alive on Earth and awake. But as soon as they go to sleep, the person's no longer, the spirit body is no longer connected to the physical body. Or when I say connected, it still remains connected with a cord, but it leaves the physical body and you spend time in your sleep state. In the spirit world, and at some point in the future, you have a point of recollection where you realize that every time you went to sleep, you went to a location in the spirit world, and you did things. And you've got mates there, and you've probably met up with your dad and your aunts. Does that make sense? But you just can't remember it at this point, because there's no physical location where you currently are that matches the location that will trigger the point of memory.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So it's all sounding a bit strange at this point, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But you know that you've got a physical body.
Yeah.
And you've got a spirit body, because you can see your spirit body right in front of you, you know, when you look at your hands and stuff, can't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. And that means you've still got eyes, and you've still got ears, and you've still got nose, and you've still got your body, and you know, you've still got your appendages and so forth, right?
Right.
Yeah. So you now have a body that's pretty much looks the same, but you'll find when you look in the mirror, it'll look pretty old and haggard, unfortunately, because it has had damage done to it. And I want to explain to you how the damage got done to it.
Yeah, who did that?
You did. And this is a thing to understand. But firstly, I want to explain to you how the universe is constructed. There's these 36 different dimensional locations or spheres. You're in the very first one. The very first one is quite dark, right? So that's what's creating that murky effect. And the lower you go in the first one, the darker it gets. So there's places in the first sphere that are completely dark, like the blackest night that you can imagine.
Yeah.
Right? And then there's places that are lighter and lighter as you progress, and progression is the important thing you need to learn. How do you progress?
Yeah. Right. Well, how do I get from A to B?
Yeah. Yep. Okay. So how do you progress? How do you move about? What, you know, we need to know these things. Well, the way you progress, the way God designed the universe, is each one of these dimensional locations or spheres is a condition of love. In other words, they are varying conditions of love. And there's two types of love. There's the love that you have for people, and then there's the love God has. They're the two different types of love.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, the love you have for people is like the love you had for your children, you know, particularly your son. You had a close bond with your son, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
I hope he's all right, eh?
Yeah. Well, he might have even taken over the property. You don't know.
Yeah.
Who knows, right? You don't know at this stage. You can go and find that out in a minute.
Okay.
But, you know, it's easy enough to do. All you've got to do is have a feeling for a person, and that'll take you to the person. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So you've got to have a feeling for them, and that'll take you to them.
So if I want to see my dad, I've just got to have the feeling.
Yeah. Now, if your dad is in a lower place than you are, he would find it very hard to come to you. So you would have to go to him. But if he's in a higher place than you are, then he would be able to come to you. Does that make sense? Because anybody in a higher place, and that's
so
a higher place of love.
So you're talking about levels or something?
Levels of love. Yep. So if your dad's in a more loving place than you are, in other words, he is in personally a more loving condition than you are, then he will be able to come to you and visit you. But if your dad's in a lower level of love than you are, then you will have to go to visit him because he won't be able to come and visit you. Does that make sense? So everything's now determined by what the condition of love is inside of you. And this is the thing that you need to become educated about.
Bob reckons he's in a lower place.
If he's in a lower place, you'll be able to go and see him.
Okay.
Right? And my suggestion is to not, if he's in a lower place, to not stay there with him. Because the lower place that he's in will actually be in a more scary place than you currently are. Do you follow me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't want that.
No. And
shit, is he all right then? Oh.
Well, no, he's not all right because he doesn't understand what I'm explaining to you. So you might be able to help him once you've learned a few things yourself.
All right, let's get on with it, yeah.
Yeah, you'll be able to help him, or you'll be able to help anyone who's in a lower condition than yourself as long as you learn some things. If you don't learn those things, then it's like the blind leading the blind, right? You won't be able to help anybody at all.
All right.
Yeah. Now, the way the universe is constructed is there's conditions of love. So everything is about how much love you have inside of you. So if you're in the condition where you currently are, it means that there is not a large amount of love inside of you, right? There's love that you have for some things, but you don't have love for everything. You don't have love for animals. You don't have love of knowledge. You don't have love of wisdom or any of those kind of qualities at this stage.
So I've got to have them.
Well, no, you don't got to do anything. That's the first thing that one of the things that you need to understand is that everybody has the will, their own personal will, you know, their free will, it's called.
Yeah.
So in other words, you're allowed to choose to do whatever you want. If you want to harm more people on earth, then you can choose to do that if you want. If you don't want to do that, then you can choose not to. It's based on your choice. Just like your life on earth was a lot based on your choices, right?
Hmm.
Yeah. And you had a relatively good living, right? You had enough wealth to have a pretty good life on earth.
Can't complain.
Yeah, and probably better than the average person on earth.
Oh, I don't know.
Well, when I say better, I mean better in terms of financial welfare.
Yeah, I had the place.
Yeah, you had the place and that. And I know you put all your life in that, but the average person on the planet, you know, there's 7.2 billion people on the planet and the average person on the planet doesn't have anything. Or very little.
Yeah.
So you had pretty good living, really. And in Australia, we have a pretty good living, don't we?
Yeah. When you look at some of those Asian countries.
Or African countries or whatever, you start to see how poor people are and how difficult their lives are. Part of the problem, though, is that caused you to do some things in ignorance of love. In other words, you chose, while you're on Earth, to do some things that weren't very loving to the environment or to the people or to yourself. And as a result, your condition of love degrades. And that's what's caused your body to look like it currently does.
Mm.
Does that make sense? Now, if you look at Bob's body and compare that with your body, what do you notice?
Yeah, it looks pretty healthy.
His body looks pretty good, right? How old does he look to you?
30.
All right, ask him what his age is.
Two.
What's his age?
Two. I reckon he's 95.
Yeah, and he looks 30.
How did he manage that?
Well, that's a great question, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So just because you see a person and they look young, it doesn't mean they are young in the spirit world. And just because you see...
Holy, yeah.
Does that make sense?
How do you sort anything out up here?
Well, everything's based around love. So Bob's body looks the way it does because he's learnt things about love that you haven't learnt yet.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, if you want to confirm that with him, you can do so now. So what's he saying about it?
Yeah. So he reckons we've got a lot to talk about.
Yep, I agree. I agree. But
he's saying you're right.
Yeah. Yep.
That's what it's all about. I just never thought about this stuff.
No. Well, most people on earth don't, right? We're pretty self-involved in our life. We don't think very much about other people when we're on earth generally. And so we don't have much consideration for what might happen when we pass. We also have no clearly defined viewpoint of the future. And so we sort of believe that everything will, you know, will go along until we die. And then when we die, then we'll work it out then. It's generally the way we go. And most people on earth, or a lot of people.
That makes sense to me.
Yeah. And a lot of people on earth don't realize that if you haven't worked it out before you pass, then there's a high likelihood that you won't work it out afterwards for a long time.
So why are they teaching this in schools then?
Well, because the average person on earth has the same viewpoint you had at the beginning of our conversation, which was anybody who explains anything about spirits or anything is a bit of an idiot.
Yeah, fair enough.
All right. So if the average person on earth believes, you know, it's idiotic to discuss these kind of things, then of course the average person on earth is not going to receive an education about those particular things.
Makes sense, huh? Yep.
Yep. So here we are. Your body is telling you your condition of love, and Bob's body is telling you his condition of love. Right? Now what he's going to do, he's going to give you a picture, like a video, of where he currently lives. What do you notice?
Looks good.
Looks pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, really pretty, beautiful location, friendly people.
Yeah.
Lovely dwellings.
Yeah, really nice.
Pretty, pretty vegetation. Yeah, probably no shooting pigs there.
Don't know. There's a lot of wide open spaces. Looks pretty nice.
Yeah.
But yeah.
You ask him. Is there any shooting of any animals there?
No.
No. Okay, so there's a bit of an issue there for you already about love that you can think about.
Well, you want to talk about the pigs now? Because they're a bloody nuisance.
Well, that's the attitude you have towards them, but you don't realise a lot of things about love that causes those particular things to occur. Animals become feral because of the human condition, and that's what the average person on earth doesn't understand either.
It's true.
In a sense, this is something Bob already knows, but you don't know yet. See, the average person on earth explains away a lot of unloving behaviour by saying, you know, things like you just said. Oh, but they're just a nuisance, so get rid of them.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Well, and
in some ways, your own death has been caused by your desire to get rid of pigs. And that's something that you haven't even considered at this point. See, if you weren't shooting at the time, then you'd probably, possibly even still be alive on earth.
All right. I'm just going to shut up and listen, all right?
you can talk about it. It's good to raise any issues you have now because I can explain what's going on. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yep. No, it's just a lot to take in.
Yeah, it is. It is.
It's a lot to think about. I've never thought about this kind of stuff before.
I know. And you're being pretty patient to stay in the conversation under those circumstances. So that's good.
Well, you're giving me some answers. And
not only that, can you feel that your fear isn't as great now?
Yeah, this Bob fella coming along has really helped things.
Yeah, so, you know, but the problem is Bob's going to have to leave at some point. So what we want to do is educate you as much as we can while we've got you here.
Why can't he just take me to where he lives?
Because your condition of love wouldn't allow you to live there.
So what have I got to do?
You've got to learn about love. That's
all right.
There's two ways to learn it, two types of love to learn about.
It's like someone just changed all the rule book.
Yes, the rules have always been the same, but on earth the rules are completely different, of course, because man made the rules on earth.
Hard work is how you get by on earth.
Yeah, but you don't get by that way in the spirit world. You can work as hard as you want.
Someone
and
showed
not
me gave me a shovel right now and said, I've got to dig a hole until I can get to that place, I'll do it.
I know, but you wouldn't be able to do it by digging a hole or having a shovel or
that's
building
what I mean.
Something.
Like, this is sense. Hard now.
That's why it's really important to show you what is involved, because if you don't understand what's involved, it's going to be a long time before you live in a happy place. You follow?
Yeah. Okay.
Now, how do you feel about just briefly going and seeing where your dad is? Because I've explained to you that it's going to be a scarier place than where you currently are. Remember?
Yeah.
If Bob's with you.
Yeah. Okay.
Then would you mind if he just took you there briefly? You'll probably want to come back as soon as you can.
Well, I'd like to see my dad and see what's happening.
Yeah, but there's a high likelihood he won't even recognise you. Because
I look bad.
Well, not only that, he also, you know, you'll probably find him almost unrecognisable too, aside from the feelings that you feel from him. And also because he's in a condition where it's not easy for him to see things beyond his own belief systems. Does that make sense? So he may not even recognize you. So don't be disappointed if he doesn't. You follow?
Yeah, all right. He had a hard life, my dad. I wouldn't say, you know.
Well, he had a hard life, but he also caused hardship for others. It's probably the best way to put it.
Well, I thought he did the best he could, you know, given his hard life.
Yeah, well, obviously God doesn't agree with you. Otherwise he would be in a better position than he currently is.
Bloody hell, it is all fire and brimstone, isn't it?
No, it's not all fire and brimstone. There's no hell that you've seen, is there? There's no hell fire or torment.
Well,
it
seems pretty bad. It was pretty bad for me.
It was pretty bad, but again, caused by some things that you're still not aware of. So that's why I'm saying to you, if you can go and visit your dad and then come back and we can continue our conversation, that will help, because that will help. We'll be able to explain some more things to you about it.
Yeah, all right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So let's do that, if you're okay with that.
Yeah, no, it's not real good there.
No. It's worse there than where you are, right?
Oh, he looks terrible.
Yeah.
Oh. It's like he's... Oh.
Yeah. What does he look like?
Terrible. Oh, he looks like it. Oh.
He looks like his skin's coming off of him and he's...
Yeah, he looks evil.
Yeah. That's the true condition of love that he's in. Yeah. See, people on Earth don't realise that the real condition of even their closest, companions.
Oh, I've got to get out of here. Yeah, we're going. Yeah. Oh, yuck, that was horrible. What did he do to deserve that? Oh, no. He wasn't the best dad in the world, but gee whiz.
Well, this is the thing you firstly need to come to realise, is that all of God's laws are just. So he is where he is because the law demands it. And you are where you are because the law demands it. And God's laws are not like people's laws. People, laws you can break pretty much any time you want, and you can get away with it, and you can manipulate it and obfuscate and move about and try to avoid all of the people's laws, but you can't do that with God's laws. That's the first thing you need to understand.
So it's like we're in prison or something?
In a way. You're in a place of probation is probably the better way of putting it. You haven't learnt about love, and your dad's learnt far less about love than you have.
And well, why isn't someone like you helping him?
Because he doesn't want help at this point. He wants to continue his evil at this point. He wants to continue harming others at this point.
Mm.
He's angry. Could you feel his anger when you were there?
Yeah.
What did you notice? Well, he looked evil, right?
Yeah.
And?
looked rabid. He looked
like a frenzy.
Yeah.
A rabid frenzy.
Almost like a demon.
Yeah.
Like, that you see.
Exactly.
In pictures.
Exactly. And why is he in that condition? Is the question, and the answer is, not only did he do a whole heap of things on earth that were out of harmony with love, but after he passed, he decided to continue doing things out of harmony with love, which worsened his condition until he got to the point where he is currently.
But so it's worse for him now than it was.
When he passed, he could have chosen to do what you're doing right now, which is you've had 31 years in spirit world without you knowing, and your dad was similar in some ways, and yet as soon as he began to know where he was, he decided he wanted to harm other people because he was angry about it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And that caused him to take further actions that are out of harmony with love, which caused a degradation of his condition physically, and that's why he looks the way he currently looks to you now.
So you're saying these levels?
Yes.
You can go down.
Yes.
How do you get up?
By learning about love.
Well, how do I do that?
Well, that's the thing, is that you need to be open to learning about the two types of love. There's two types of love. And you're very anti-religion, right?
Yeah.
Yep. And what I'm going to explain to you involves God but doesn't involve religion. Right. So what I'm going to say to you is that God exists. There is a God. And the laws that you're now governed by are God's laws. Right. And those laws are immovable. You can't change the law. You can only change yourself. Do you follow? So you can't manipulate the law. You can only change yourself. And all the laws are based around love. So that means the more loving you become, and you've got two ways of becoming more loving, but the more loving you become, the more you'll be able to get out of the darker conditions and into the brighter conditions. That's what Bob's done. So you, in Bob, you can see a contrast between Bob and your dad, right?
Yeah.
All right. Now, what I want to do is get Bob to show you what he looked like when he passed.
Sort of like me, really.
Like you, yeah. So he obviously learnt whatever the way is to get out of the current condition and into his new condition, didn't he?
Yeah.
Now, ask him how many years it took him to learn that. How old was he when he passed?
25, he reckons.
Yeah. So how many years did it take him to get from where he was at 25 years of age in your condition? So when he passed, his body, even though he was 25 years old on earth, his body looked like, how old does your body look like now?
I don't know.
You look like you're 80 or 90 at least, don't you?
Yeah, at least. Looks pretty bad.
Looks pretty bad, yeah. And his body at 25 looked like that because he'd done a bit of damage of love on earth.
Yeah.
That makes sense. And as a result, his spirit body looked pretty bad when he passed. And how many years did it take him to learn about how to get out of his condition?
Good 50, he reckons.
Yeah.
Good 50.
Yeah. And then once he learnt the way, which way did he learn?
Well, and this is what he's saying to me. He learnt God's way.
Yeah, and you've got a choice.
Yeah.
You can learn your own way or God's way.
Yeah.
Now, he tried his own way for 50 years or so. Didn't work very well.
Oh, look, I don't want any of this stuff where they just tell me I'm wrong and I'm bad and it's all sin and all this stuff. Oh, I can't handle that. It's just
well,
coming on strong.
How long you decide you can't handle it for is how long you're going to be where you are.
So all those bloody... Well, I don't want to...
No, go on. Say what you want to say. It's okay. It's good. The first thing to do is be truthful and honest about what you feel. So,
well, all the bloody wankers we saw going to church every bloody... They were right about all this.
No, they weren't. Let Bob show you where some of they are. How about that?
Holy mackerel.
Where are some of those?
Yeah, well, it's varied.
Varied, yes. between.
Some of them aren't that far from my dad.
Correct. And then the other ones of them are in a nice place, right?
Pretty nice.
Yeah.
So how does that happen? They're all going to the
It's obviously not about the belief systems that they had, obviously, huh?
Well, I don't know.
If they all had the same belief system, you'd think that all be in the same place. Would make sense, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that's why I don't understand.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's the condition of love inside of you that determines your place. So there are some pretty nasty people who are religious, and they are in the hells where your dad is. That's called the hells of the spirit world. Does that make sense?
So I just don't get it. On one hand, you're telling me God is there.
Yes.
On the other hand, you're telling me all those churches were some of them were right and some of them were wrong, but they all had the same ideas. And so what?
So what I'm saying.
What ideas am I supposed to have?
Well, this is what I want to explain to you.
All right, sorry.
Good question, though. What I want to explain to you is that if people who had the same belief systems intellectually arrived in different places in the spirit world, then that should tell you that they were all in different conditions of love. So some of them were in okay conditions of love.
What's this condition of love thing?
Well, that's what I want to explain. What you see in front of you, Bob, is in a good condition of love. So that's what a good condition of love looks like.
So he looks good.
He looks good. He looks young, right? He looks pretty happy, right?
And how do I get it?
He's still got further progress he can make. Isn't that true?
Yeah.
Yeah, he agrees with that.
Yeah.
Yeah. But he's learnt some basic things about condition of love and how to improve his condition. Right?
Yeah, he reckons he's got heaps more to learn.
Yeah.
He reckons he's just begun, really.
So of those 36 dimensions, where is he? Which one of those dimensions is he in? What number?
5, he reckons.
5, yeah. So that's how good you'll look when you're at 5.
Well, how do I get there?
Exactly. But the trouble is, me explaining how you get there involves explaining two things to you, which you've so far poo-hooed every single time, okay. Which is about God and love.
Well, sorry, you got to understand.
I understand.
I grew up and the carry-on, they used to carry on, and I just thought that's all just a bunch
of fake. It's nothing to do with carry-on. Right? This is a scientific truth the spirit world.
Who is this God like then?
Well, God, obviously, will not be able to see God for a start. The reason why... there's a lot of reasons why, but one of the primary reasons is that God created the universe, and if God created the universe, it makes sense that God exists outside of the universe itself, because God had to exist before the universe was created, if there is a God at all.
All right,
Does that make sense? Make logical
it's
sense to you?
It's all a bit highfalutin for me, yeah.
Yeah. So logically... It's impossible for God to exist inside the universe if God created it.
Look, mate, I'm sorry, but you just go, I just want to know how to get out of here. I don't care about all the...
But this is what I'm explaining to you, is you're going to have to care about some of these things if you're going to get out of there.
Just tell me what I've got to do.
Well, you won't understand what you've got to do unless I explain some basic principles to you.
All right, sorry.
You follow?
I'm not the sharpest tool in the stack, you know.
But even that is dependent upon your condition. So the more you look at Bob, what does he know about? The things that he knows about. You ask him about some scientific things.
Yeah, he knows a bit of stuff.
Knows a bit of stuff, right? Did he know any stuff when he passed?
Well, he knew, like me, how to run station.
Exactly. He didn't know much other than what you know right now, right? So he's obviously learned a whole heap of things as well.
Yeah, all right.
So you don't have to be what you call the sharpest tool in the stack to learn a lot of this stuff. A child can learn this stuff. So you don't.
All right. Okay.
All right? So you don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
The second thing is that I've explained to you that there's two types of love that you've got to learn about.
Yeah. Look, I've got to be honest. All this carry on about love, I don't even what are you talking about, love? I don't get love.
Well, if you can get
Isn't it what you do? That's love?
No, it's how you feel. It's not what you do, it's how you feel. Well, how you feel will motivate what you do. So for example, you felt like killing pigs, correct?
Well, it's what you do.
No, you decided to do it.
Yeah.
You felt like doing it.
Yeah.
If you loved pigs more, you wouldn't have done it.
It's pretty funny to think of loving pigs.
I know. For you at the moment, it's funny. But
I'm
for
going
Bob,
to be a pig lover.
But for Bob, is that a problem?
No.
Okay. So.
Yeah, all right. He, yeah.
So what's the point?
He's been trying to tell me about when Jeffrey was born.
Yep, your son?
Yep.
Yep. And what is he trying to tell you about it?
Just to remember.
To remember the feeling you had, right?
Yep.
What's the feeling you had?
I don't know, I was real proud. Yeah, had a son.
Pretty amazing.
He was pretty, so little.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a feeling of love.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it, really, that he was ours. And
yeah, yeah.
He was so perfect.
Yeah, it's a wonderful thing God's done, given us the gift to procreate, because it gives us that ability to have those feelings, right?
Oh, I don't really go for feelings much.
That's the problem. Ask Bob whether he goes for feelings.
Yeah.
All right. Isn't happiness a feeling?
I suppose so.
Isn't like fear a feeling?
Yeah, I just never really thought about it.
Exactly. So, well, I'm talking about feelings, but all the problem is here is that you just haven't thought about it before, that's all.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Love is a feeling, not a thought. It's not an action, it's not a thought, it's a feeling. It will motivate thoughts and actions.
So I've got to get more of the feeling
of love like inside of you, like you had when you had born. Towards your son, but towards a lot of different things, not just your son.
Okay.
So your attitude towards love was you love some things on earth, but there was most of the things on earth you didn't love. And then you loved a whole heap of things that were quite bad to do or unloving to do to other things. So shooting pigs, for example, is one of those things. Does that make sense?
Yeah, all right.
So what I'm trying to suggest to you is that there's the love that comes out of your heart to other things. Some of the things that you had love for were like your son and your daughter. You had love for them. Not as much love for your wife, although when you met her, you had some. Right?
Yeah.
But after a while, you sort of lost that really, didn't you? Feelings.
Well, I reckon I really only had that feeling about Jeff and my mates.
Yep.
I've never felt like that about...
About a woman?
No.
Not really, huh? Why do you reckon that is?
Oh,
what do you reckon your dad's attitude to women is?
Well, my mum was a bit of a so-and-so, really.
She was hard to get along with, bossy.
She wasn't around much.
That caused you to not feel much attraction to women except for sex, right?
Yeah, Bob's telling me stuff, though, too, while you're talking.
Like what?
I don't get all this stuff, eh? Well, he reckons that Mum wasn't that bad.
Not as bad as...
His dad was the mongrel.
Yeah, do you want to see where your mum is?
Holy shit. It's pretty nice.
It's pretty nice. Is it as nice as where Bob is?
Bob just showed me. Nah.
No, not as nice.
But it's decent.
It's not bad.
Oh, gee whiz, this is all too much.
So your mum obviously has some more love in her heart than what your dad does.
Oh, I don't get it. Well, what? Oh, yeah, all right.
Remember, God's laws are unchangeable. So one of the things you've got to come to terms with, if you're going to live your life in the spirit world, is that if somebody's in a better place than another person, that it's because they have a better condition of love than the other person. There's no other reason. It's not like God found them like a favourite or anything. God doesn't play favourites, right? So where you are is where you are because of the condition of love that's in your soul.
All right, all right.
And it's very important you get that, because if you don't get that, then you won't be able to progress.
Yeah, okay, right. You got to have this feel and stuff.
You got to have the feeling of
love.
All right.
So how do I start?
Well, what you've got to do is let go of all the feelings that are not loving. Right?
Well, I don't know what's loving and what's not.
Of course you don't. That's part of the problem. That's why you're where you are right now. Whereas Bob knows a lot more about love, doesn't he? Because he's in a different place. He obviously knows a lot more about love.
Yeah.
So the key is to learn as much as you possibly can about love without sort of having all this judgment that you have about it. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Like when you rubbish it, you're basically saying, you know, that's judgment towards it. And if you have judgment towards it, you won't do it. And if you don't do it, you won't progress. And if you don't progress, you won't get out of where you are.
So Bob's going to help me learn, is he, or what?
Well, yeah, but can I explain a few more things? So we've talked mostly at this stage about the love you have inside of you, haven't we?
Yeah.
And you can recognise love about for your son. You didn't have as much love for your daughter, right?
Oh, I loved her.
You loved her, but you didn't have as much love for her as you did for your son.
Well, I don't know.
Do you know why?
She's a girl.
Exactly.
It's a woman thing. Like
exactly. That's different. That's a part of your definition of love. You think women and men are so different, and that causes you not want to understand women. And
you can't understand women.
Of course you can.
Different creatures.
No, you can understand women. Bob understands women better than you do.
Oh, all right.
And he's had to learn to do that. Before he had it, when he left the earth, he had a terrible viewpoint of women, right?
Right.
How did he? What did he think of women before he left the earth? What were they there for, really?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Carry on the family line.
That's all they were there for.
Look after.
Cook for you.
Yeah, the meals, laundry. Yeah, so he's a lot like me, really.
He's a lot like you, yeah. That's why he was in a similar condition to you when he passed. But he's had to learn about love. And in the process of learning about love, he's had to learn about how he's treated women and how he's treated other guys and how he's treated animals and how he treated the environment, how he treated the earth, and how he treated other people. He's had to learn about a lot of different things, and you're going to have to do the same if you want to progress.
But I've got to just, like, it's pretty bad here.
Yep.
How am I going to learn anything? It's bloody awful. I can't think about anything.
Well, it's totally based on your desire to learn.
Okay.
See, every time I've explained something to you that challenges you, you have a tendency to rubbish it. Well, that's going to make it hard to learn. You've got to remember that it's only a few minutes ago that you were so frightened that you didn't even know where you were.
Well, that's right. It's a lot to take in.
It is a lot to take in. I understand. But can you see already that me just educating you a little bit about love and educating you a little bit about how the spirit world works has helped you feel a lot more calmer and has helped you understand a lot more?
Yeah, yeah. I don't mean to give you a hard time.
That's
I
all
don't.
Right. That's all right. But you can see the more that you learn, the better off you're going to be, is what I'm suggesting to you.
Yeah, all right. So all right. I just got to...
So let's talk about a little bit about the feelings of love. So we've talked about the first set of feelings, which are coming from inside of you.
Mm.
So that's the problem, is that there are not many feelings coming from inside of you that are loving at this point from God's perspective.
Okay.
Now, there's two ways you can improve that. One way is by improving it through your own effort. All right? In other words, you'll have to learn everything that you've done wrong out of harmony with love. You'll have to see it's out of harmony with love. You'll have to want to see it's out of harmony with love. And then you'll have to want to correct it in some way.
Mm.
In other words, if we introduce the term sin, if we look at the term sin as sin is, it comes from an old Greek word that means missing the mark of perfection. So imagine you're at a target with a gun and you miss the bullseye.
Yeah.
Well, from God's definition, that's sin.
All right.
Does that make sense?
It's pretty fine margin then.
Yeah, pretty fine margin. Bullseye every time is God's definition of perfect. See?
Yeah.
Okay, so if you imagine that, then that means that every time you have done something out of harmony with love, and that's missing the mark, all right, then you've sinned. Every time you've sinned, there was a penalty for that sin. on your soul, which has caused your body to look darker. And the more you sin, the darker it becomes. Your father has sinned far more than you have, and as a result, his condition is much darker.
But isn't this what all the churches went and did and learnt, and so they didn't sin? And so how come some of them were in a bad place?
See, they believed that believing in Jesus would cause them to stop sinning.
Yeah. You
know, that's not true. Because a lot of those churches say they believed in Jesus when they're still in hell. The way you get out of a place of sin is by your own awakening to it, your own realizations, not by relying on anybody else. You don't have to rely on Jesus or God. You rely on God, but we'll talk about that in a minute, but you don't have to rely on Jesus or any other mediator to get out of the condition you're at, right? But you will need to listen to people who are in a better condition of love than you are, otherwise you won't learn anything.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So it's very important that you listen and learn as much as you possibly can about love. Now, the first type of love, as I've told you, is the love that comes from within you. And at the moment, you've got love from within you towards some things, but not many things. And that's why your condition is like it is right now. Because there's not a developed love for a lot of things inside of you. You only have that feeling of love for very few things. So if we talk about women, you don't really have that feeling of love for a woman generally.
Mm.
If we talk about the comparison between your daughter and your son, you can see that you love your son more than your daughter. There's a stronger feeling for your son than for your daughter.
Yeah.
Right? And so that tells you that your love is selective. It's not equal. It's not... Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's a problem there from God's perspective. Right? And that's why you're in the condition you are.
All right.
Your dad's viewpoint is even worse than yours. So that's why he's in a terrible condition.
So I'm going to have to become like some kind of hippie type that just loves everything and everything's wonderful.
No, it's not like that either. Because a lot of that's fake too. Right? So you know the hippie types on earth. See, we're talking about a real feeling from your heart, not a fake presentation of a feeling. See, a lot of people on earth... give a fake presentation of a feeling. They don't really feel it.
Yeah. No, I get that.
You get that? It's going to have to be real, a feeling that's real.
But I'm going to have to love everything.
No, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to live where Bob is, you're going to do it. Does that make sense? You don't have to do it.
How do you get that feeling about everything?
Well, a lot of it's about awakening to the damage that your attitudes have caused to yourself and others and the planet. A lot of it's about that.
Okay.
Does that make sense? To see that an unloving attitude causes damage to another person or to yourself. And as a result, that is going to be very, very difficult to recover from unless you work through the attitude. So a lot of this is about your beliefs and attitudes. So when we first started our discussion, you believed that killing pigs is fine, right?
Mm.
Well, Bob doesn't feel killing pigs is fine.
Mm.
Right? So his attitudes obviously changed, but when he was on Earth, he believed killing pigs was fine.
Yeah.
Didn't he?
No, I get it a bit more now.
Yeah. So he's had to change in his attitudes, change in his belief systems. It's not like becoming a person that you're not. You don't have to be some kind of, long-haired hippie person who sprouts peace and love all the time while he doesn't really feel it. That's not what I'm suggesting. Or you don't have to become some kind of Christian who raves on about how they're saved but ends up in the hells because of their underlying attitude, right? In the end, it's the underlying attitude of love that determines where you arrive in the spirit world, and that is immaterial to what you believe. In other words, the main beliefs you have to change are beliefs about love. That's how God's constructed the universe.
All right.
And if you understand that, it's very simple, very easy after that. If you can get that, progress can be very rapid.
Yeah, well, I want to get that now.
Yeah. You can see with Bob, it took him 50 years to get that. And I'm suggesting you don't want to wait another 30 years or so where you are.
No, I'm just trying to understand what's involved, what I've got to do.
Yeah. So can you first understand that the condition of love that's inside of your soul is determining your current location in the spirit world, and your location is a, and your body is a reflection of your real condition of love? That's the first thing to understand.
No, I got it.
That makes sense?
Yep.
Okay, and if you're going to get out of this place that you currently are in the spirit world, then the only thing that you can do is through your own choice, not through being forced by anybody, even God will not force you, through your own choice, making a decision to learn more about love. That's going to be your primary goal if you're going to get out of where you are.
Yeah, I want to get on with that now.
Yeah. Now, the second type of love I haven't explained to you, which I need to explain to you, because that's the type of love that Bob has got help with, that allowed him to, after he'd spent now, so he spent 25 years on Earth, another 50 years before he even started learning, right? Really? So 75 years old now, and he's now what, 95? So in the last 20 years, he's gone from the first dimension where you are, in the, and where you are is called the sort of mid-hells of the first sphere. And he's gone from that location to his location in the fifth sphere in 20 years because he learned about this kind of love.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And this is the kind of love that God has for you. You can actually receive God's love into your heart and as a result progress much more rapidly than if you do it under your own steam.
So one's about me loving everything, or
one's about you developing your own love and growing in your own love and getting rid of your own unloving ideas and concepts and beliefs.
And now you're saying the other one is just like
asking God to receive his love.
But one's about giving love and one's about getting love.
You see, you haven't learnt the rules of God giving love yet, because there's some rules to it. There's a law to it. You understand? And the primary law about God giving you love is about repentance. In other words, you have to have an awakening to what you've done wrong. You have to be sorry for what you've done wrong. And then you'll be able to ask God to forgive you for what you've done wrong. And if that is a true feeling inside of you, then you'll receive some of God's love. You can even start the process now, because one of the things that you've been quite detuned from is having any connection with God at this point, right?
Yeah.
So you could actually say, if there is a God, I would like to feel some of that love. But it has to be a feeling that's sincere, coming from your heart. It can't be just, oh yeah, I'll give it as experiment off the top of my head. Oh, I'll just try it for on the top of my head and see how it goes, because it won't work. It has to be a feeling.
So you're saying,
now can
if
I?
God,
yep, exists,
had a feeling.
Yeah, God has feelings, by the way. But
for me,
if God has a feeling for you,
like I have for Jeff,
like you have for Jeff,
then what?
Then I'd like to feel it from God.
I never knew I could feel feelings. Like,
yeah.
So Jeff can feel my feelings for him.
And if your feelings are angry, he can feel that. If they're sad, he can feel that. If they're scared, you can feel feelings. Everybody can.
I can feel my feelings, maybe.
You can feel other people's feelings too. Why do you think where you are, you've been so scared? Because all the projection of other people's feelings at you.
I never thought of that.
You see? Yeah, everybody feels feelings. It's just how aware they are of feeling them. That makes sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, just before, when you let yourself feel about Jeff, your son, did you notice a colour coming out of you? You do it again. Do it again, and this time observe. Let yourself feel about when he was just born, and you're looking at him and holding him.
Yeah.
Right? And what do you notice? There's a colour coming out of you now, right?
Yeah.
What's the colour?
It's like, part of it's like pale bluey and part of it's pale pinky.
Yeah. Pale blue and pink, Blue is about truth. So you're in a state of truth here where you want to feel, you know, the truth about how you feel about your son. And the pale pink is a is the feeling of love for you that you have for your son. Does that make sense?
Right.
Okay. Now, colours in the spirit world denote the feelings. They show you what the feelings are. So did you see what colours were coming out of your dad when you visited him?
No.
No, well, you didn't. You didn't spend that much time looking, right? But there's black and browns and oranges.
Everything was black and brown there.
Yeah, but really dark colours coming out of him, like wisps going out to different people and places.
Mm.
Now, one thing you wouldn't realise is that when you feel that feeling for your son, did you notice that the colour went somewhere?
Yeah, it went away from me.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's actually going away from you and entering your son. So that's how you find your
son.
Truly. That's how you find him. You just follow the colour. Yeah. You feel for him and follow the colour. You'll be able to find him that way.
Great.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All right.
Can I go do that?
Yeah, but please come back because there's a lot more to tell you yet.
All right, Bob only let me go a little bit.
Yeah, because you would have stayed there a lot longer.
He's all right, though.
He's all right? Yeah. He's on Earth?
Yeah.
Yep, alive?
Yeah.
Where was he? Did you see his surroundings?
Yeah, he's got his own place. He's
got his own place.
Yeah, he's got a family.
Got a family, kids.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. So you'll be able to check him out.
Yeah, I really want to go back.
Yeah, but see, again, you've got to be careful about this because if you go back now and we don't finish the rest of the conversation, then you don't learn a whole heap of things. And then, you know, already what you're learning is benefiting you, right? You wouldn't have known how to find your son before.
No.
So, you know, these are all important things to learn when you're in the spirit world. Okay. Now, remember we talked about the feeling you had for your son, and the reason why I brought up this feeling you had for your son, there's a colour to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. When you have a real feeling for God, similar colours will come out of you for God. Does that make sense? That's how you know you've got a real feeling or just something that's in your head.
So I've got to have the feeling that I have for Jeff for God before I can
You have to have a longing.
Get a feeling for God.
Well, you have to have a longing for God to give you that feeling that you have for Jeff. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah.
So in other words, you're the recipient now. You have to have a longing to be the receiver of that feeling. It's a bit hard for you because your dad was pretty bad with you, and it's pretty hard to think of God as a loving God, and your mum wasn't that crash hot with you either. She was pretty detuned, and so it's hard for you to think of God as your mum being a loving God as well. So it's going to have some belief systems to work through here before you probably be able to generate that feeling.
Mm.
But one way you can experiment with it initially is just have a pure feeling that you want to know the truth whether God exists or not. And the way to confirm it is to ask God that if he does exist, can he give you a feeling that he exists?
Holy mackerel.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I like it.
Well, because it makes you cry.
Yeah.
And you don't like crying much, right? And that's part of the problem, is that you're going to have to let yourself feel some emotions if you do it this way. You follow?
Yeah.
Yeah, but what did you get? Did you notice where it came from?
Somewhere away from me.
Yep.
Suddenly, I just felt sure.
For sure?
God's real.
God's real, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, gee whiz, that wasn't so bad.
No, but it meant that you had to, you almost wanted to cry, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you should have let yourself cry probably, right? Because then you would have received more of that feeling. You see, it's allowance of the emotion that will allow the feeling to continue. And you shut down the emotion, which shuts down the feeling. Do you follow?
Mm.
You remember when you had that feeling of love for your son, you started crying, really, you teared up, started feeling like sad or emotional? That's okay. That's how God created you to be emotional. And while you have that feeling, the colour comes out of you, right?
Yeah.
While you have a feeling that you want to know the truth from God, well, God will want to share the truth with you.
It's not like I thought.
No, it's not like a thought. It involves thoughts.
No, it's not like I thought it was going to be.
No, it's not like you thought either, is it? Well, you didn't even have a thought about it, did you? Of any kind?
God.
No.
No, I just thought churchy stuff.
Yeah, yeah. But it's not like that at all. God's a real being. But God's not interested in church, which makes sense.
Thank goodness.
Thank goodness. There's been a lot of things done in the name of religion
over
there.
Kneeling, standing, singing.
And wars and whatever else that have been all caused in the name of religion. You know, I'm sure God's, you know, you feel, is God impressed by religion on earth?
I don't know.
Well, ask for God to give you confirmation about how God feels. This is how you find out. Ask God for the truth about how he feels about earth-based religions.
Oh, wow. They got it all wrong.
Yeah. Why? Why have they got it all wrong? What was the feeling that came with that you had?
Well, none of it's right.
That's right.
It's all hurting.
It's all hurting people, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and in fact, this is one of the reasons why many people who are religious have passed into the hells just like your dad has, because it's hurt people. You know, a lot of what religions believe is not true.
I don't know. I think I've got to go now. It's so much now. Yeah. I'm just completely overwhelmed.
Well, this is the other thing I'd like to say to you. Allow yourself, the more you allow yourself to be overwhelmed by emotion, the faster the process will occur between where you are and where Bob is. The more you shut down your feelings of emotion, the slower the process will occur.
Okay.
Now, the thing that you've learned is that you can ask God anything.
Yeah.
And get answers, as long as you're open to receiving those answers emotionally. Right? And you've also learned that if you allow yourself to be emotionally overwhelmed, that you'll progress faster than if you haven't allowed yourself to be emotionally overwhelmed. Now, as a result of receiving a little bit of God's love just now, if you look at your environment,
yeah, it's a bit better.
It's a bit better, just a little bit.
Right? Well, actually, it's heaps better.
Yeah.
It's heaps better. I didn't see Bob was there and that made it better, but yeah. He just went away while I did that.
And yeah.
It's better. It's heaps better.
Yeah. And also...
So this is all I've got to do.
It's all you've got to do. It's all you've got to do. But it has to be sincere. It has to come from your heart. It can't be something you just manufacture in your head. And you have to have some kind of awakening as to the sin. You have to have some kind of personal desire to move yourself through these places by desiring God's love and also letting yourself cry, which is a part of the repentance process. Does that make sense?
So I should go back over my whole life, ask God what the truth is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is how you treated your wife what God would have liked? You ask God that.
Oh, I can't handle it.
No.
Oh,
okay.
No.
So just Okay. See, now this is where you're shutting down emotion. So this is what you've got to learn to not do, right? But I did that just to give you an example right? Now, there's one other thing I need to show you, right? What can help you is that there is already a list of all the things that are unloving that you've done in your life in front of you.
A list?
Yeah. It's just that you don't want to see it. And it's only when you want to see it that you'll see it. Do you follow?
Like magic.
It's not really magic, it's a law. There's a law that whatever is in your soul can be easily seen by others. So Bob can easily see what the list is.
Yeah, all right.
But it's up to your use of your will as to what you want to see. You have to want to see it before you'll see it.
Yeah.
It's a bit like, you know, you're going to have to want to desire love in your life more before you'll love life more. It's all based upon free will, this gift that God has given you. It's a real precious gift. God's given you this gift so that you can make choices of your own. He doesn't want to force choices on you, but he is going to tell you when those choices are unloving through the laws. The laws have an effect on your soul, which is not your spirit body, by the way. It's your, you could think of it as your heart, your feelings. That's your soul. And the laws have an effect on the soul.
Okay, so Bob's showing me his list.
Yep.
So I just need to get
He's showing his list from when he first began?
Yeah.
Yep. And what about his list now? Does he...
Well, it's a pretty short list.
Pretty short list, yeah. Can you see the difference?
It's not really like a list, yeah.
So he's, you know, at the beginning it was pretty long list.
Yeah.
Yeah, your list is probably going to be pretty close to the same length.
All right, so I know what to do now.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
But you have to want to know. You see, when you started thinking about your wife, you didn't want to know. And because you didn't want to know, you started shutting it down. When you start to shut it down, you feel terrible. Instead of just allowing yourself to feel terrible, allow yourself to be sorry for what you've done, you feel terrible and you start punishing yourself and those kind of things. That doesn't work, right? You need to allow yourself to feel sorry about it. That's all that needs to happen.
Yep.
That's called repentance. You follow me?
Yeah.
And most people on earth and in the spirit world refuse to get into a state of repentance. In other words, it has to be forced upon them, almost like. Now, God doesn't force anything, but the law does. So one way the law is forcing it upon you at the moment is that you are in your current condition because the law is saying you have to be there. And you can't get out of that condition unless you work through this awakening process to seeing, wanting to see what you've done wrong and then doing something about it.
Okay.
Taking some action. Whether that action be asking for God's love, which will be an overwhelming process emotionally. You will be crying a fair bit there.
Mm.
Or whether it's a process where you try through some personal effort. And my suggestion is to not do that, because a person could take hundreds or even thousands of years to get out of where you are if they do it through their own effort, in comparison to, you know, a few years to get out of where you are. And you can almost every day be in a new place if you do it the other way.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, there are the basic things that you need to understand, that God has laws. Though all the laws are about love, it's about you learning about love. You can change your location and your condition by learning about love, but it has to be a sincere thing. It can't be faked. It can't be manufactured. It can't be intellectualized.
Mm-hmm.
It can't be, it's not based on a religion, any kind of religion that people here on earth know anyway. It's the real religion, which is the religion of love, basically.
Mm.
Right? And if you understand those basic principles, you will be able to progress in the spirit world, and you won't have to go back to that place where you began when we first discussed things with you, you know, how you were so frightened and terrified about where you were.
Yeah, I don't want to go back there.
Yeah. And you don't want to wait another 31 years before you feel another emotion. You follow?
Yeah.
Because you not wanting to feel the emotion of fear kept you where you were for 31 years.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Right.
Because you didn't want to feel the emotion of fear. You stayed there for that period of time until you were prepared to feel the emotion of fear.
Ah. Okay.
And the same applies to all the other emotions. So this applies especially to the emotions of grief. You've got things to grieve and you've got things to be sorry for. And, you know, if you don't let yourself cry, then you'll stay in a condition for a long period of time until you let yourself cry. There's other emotions you have of shame, guilt as well. And then as more and more of those more unpleasant emotions drop off, you'll feel more and more happy emotions.
Right.
Okay. And like when you look at Bob, he's pretty happy, right?
Seems pretty happy.
Seems pretty happy. Most people where he lives are pretty happy.
Okay. Thanks, mate. You've really helped me out.
It's my pleasure. How about we thank the girl you've been talking through as well? Her name's Mary.
Yeah, she did all right.
She did all right, didn't she? Managed to stay connected to you even when you were terrified. That's pretty good, because if that didn't happen, then we probably wouldn't have been able to have this conversation.
Right.
Mm.
I feel like I've got a lot to learn.
Yeah, I agree.
I don't know if I feel anything yet, but I reckon I've got a lot to learn.
Yeah. Can I just remind you of a few things?
Yeah.
You learnt already that if you follow the colours, it'll take you to places, right?
Yeah.
So this is how you can find your son, you can find your daughter, you can find where your wife was, you can find your dad, you can find your mum, you can find, you know, anybody right. really.
Yeah.
Aunt, uncle, whatever, your mates if they've passed, and you'll be able to see their condition. As soon as you see their condition, if you see their condition is darker than your own, and they look more terrible than you'd look yourself, then you know they're in a worse condition than you. And there's little you can do to help them unless you learn more about love yourself. All right?
Yeah, all right.
And if you find some that are in a brighter condition than you, there are some that are in a brighter condition than you that have not learned about God's love yet. They've got into a brighter condition by doing their own thing, you know, by their own effort.
Yeah.
And you'll be able to talk to them about God's love, you know, what you just experimented with that experiment that you did regarding...
So I can just tell them to do the same thing?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly the same. But it has to be a real feeling, you see. It has to be a feeling coming out of them. It can't be just a thought.
Yeah.
It has to be a sincere feeling. Something.
It's strange, this whole feeling thing.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll take a little while for you to get used to it. After a while, you realise that when you're a child, you used to have feelings a lot more than when you do now. Does that make sense? The way God created us naturally is that we should feel. And when we have our life on earth, we often are detuned from feeling through our family environment.
Yeah, right.
And that's your family environment. Your dad basically belted out your feelings, if you think about it.
Yeah, I thought he was just doing...
You thought he was just disciplining you for doing the wrong thing or whatever, but the reality is he also stopped you from feeling. And it hasn't helped him any.
Yeah, right.
Mm.
Yeah. Oh, I really thank you.
Yeah.
It's
good to know the truth, isn't it?
Describe how bad it was.
Yeah. Well, 31 years terrified is a fair time to be terrified.
Oh, I just never thought I'd ever get out of it.
Mm. Yeah.
But I can see the work I've got to do now.
Yeah. Yeah. And if you're prepared to see the list, you know, it takes a bit of courage to see the list.
Yeah.
Takes a bit of courage to feel the emotions, you know. And if you have less judgment about emotion, that'll be good. Because otherwise, every time you cry, you feel bad about yourself for crying, you know, like the average guy on earth would feel. That's not going to be much good for you. So, you know, you've got to get rid of some of this judgment that you have about emotion.
Yeah, I don't like crying in front of blokes.
No.
I don't really like crying.
No, but you can do a lot of crying by yourself or with God anyway, you know. Remember that every time you want to know something, you can easily ask God about it. If you're open to receive the answer, God will give you the answer. But you have to be open to receiving. It's like, you know, if you use your will to go, oh, I don't want to know that, then you won't hear anything from God about it.
Mm.
Yeah.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. No worries. Well, it's been great to talk to you.
Yeah, and thanks for introducing me to Bob.
My pleasure.
He's going to help me.
He will help you.
Yeah. That's such good news.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not that good with words.
Yeah. One of the things you have to become aware of is you're going to make new friends and you'll also have new acquaintances, you know. The key is to just go with the flow a bit, you know.
Yeah.
But also work through it emotionally and understand that how fast you progress and how long it takes you to get out of where you are is completely dependent upon your real desire to love and your desire or your desire to receive God's love. One of those two things.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Okay. Well, As I said, I can't really express my thanks, but
yeah,
thanks.
Yeah. It's a pleasure. It's always great to help somebody.
Oh, wow.